Hello everyone, I'm Jacob Kaufman, I'm the Nerd on the Street, and today I'm showing you how to stream and record from OBS at different qualities. Alright everyone, so here at Nerd on the Street, I stream every now and then, and I use the open source program Open Broadcaster Software, or OBS Studio, to do that. Now my internet upload speed here isn't the greatest, so I can normally only stream at 720p 30fps. However, I still like to record my streams and upload them to YouTube later, sometimes after I edit them, and those recordings I like to have at a higher quality. So it's actually pretty easy in OBS to record your stream at a higher resolution and bitrate than you're streaming at. I'm going to cut to the desktop right now and show you how to do it yourself. Alright guys, and here I am on my desktop. I am going to go ahead and open up OBS Studio, and I did reset mine to factory default settings to show you how to do this today. So you can see it's asking me if I want to run the auto configuration wizard. We can go ahead and do that just to get started, and it really doesn't matter what you select here. You can optimize for streaming or recording. I'm going to leave mine on streaming because we will be streaming. Now right off the bat here, the base canvas resolution you want to set to a resolution that you're going to be recording at, so the highest resolution that you would like to output at. For me, that's going to be 1920 by 1080. We're going to set the stream to stream at 720p later, but the base resolution, the canvas resolution, has to be the higher of the two resolutions. Now FPS is the one thing that you can't do per encoder. If you're recording at 30fps, you have to be streaming at 30fps. If you're recording at 60, you have to be streaming at 60. That's the one thing you cannot customize as of right now. So we are going to go ahead and set ours to 30fps. But you can of course select 60 if you'd like yours to be at 60. Now the service here, I usually use a custom streaming service because I have a restreaming server. It's kind of like restream.io, but it's one that I made myself, so I don't have to pay anybody for it. However, for our demo today, I'm going to use Smashcast because the streaming website is kind of dead, and I don't want to email anybody following me on Twitch or Mixer saying that I'm streaming when I'm actually just making this video. So of course I'll go ahead and log into my Smashcast account. I'm going to grab my stream key, which I'm not going to show you on video, and I am going to paste that right into OBS here. Now the bitrate we are going to set manually, and like I said before, my upload speed is not that great. So normally I have my bitrate set to 2000 kilobits per second, or about 2 megabits per second upload. Sometimes I have to bump it down to 1800 if things are getting really bad with my internet, but 2000 usually works okay. So we're going to set that for our streaming bitrate. Once again, you can set this to whatever you want to stream at. We're going to adjust all this stuff after we're done with the wizard. And we'll continue on here and apply those settings. Now, in our settings here, in the full OBS settings, we are going to adjust a couple things. I'm going to change my theme real quick to one that I prefer. But next, we need to head over to the video section. And once again, like I said, we want to set our base canvas resolution to the higher quality, higher resolution that you're going to want to record at. And you also want your output scaled resolution to be that same higher quality. So 1920 by 1080 in my case. Even though we're going to be streaming in 720p, you want both of the things in the video tab to match up with the higher resolution that you're recording at. The downscale filter doesn't really matter right now because these are the same resolution. Once again, set your FPS to whatever you want it to be set to. And now for the majority of this configuration, we're going to head over to the output section. We're going to change output mode to advanced, and now you can see we have separate tabs for streaming and recording, as well as audio and replay buffer, which we aren't going to look at today. So over on our streaming tab, we're just going to finalize our settings here. The encoder that we're using is X264, which is software encoding. If you have an NVIDIA graphics card, which I don't in this computer, you can use NVNC. I've got a Threadripper here, so I'm fine using software encoding. Now down here in our streaming output settings, once again, here's where we can set what we actually want to stream to. So once again, we're selecting constant bitrate because that's what most streaming websites require. Like I said, I normally upload at about 2000 kilobits per second. Our keyframe interval needs to be 2 for Smashcast, and everything else you can set to whatever you want. And finally, obviously, to set a different resolution for our stream than our recording is going to have, under the streaming tab, we're going to come down here and select rescale output. And here we can just select whatever resolution we want, in this case 1280 by 720. Sometimes this doesn't show up in the dropdown, and if that's the case, you can just type in 1280 by 720. So now our stream is going to get rescaled to 1280 by 720. Next, we're going to come over to the recording tab, and once again, we can set our specific options for the recordings. You can set your recording path here. We are going to change the format. The default is FLV, which is of course very difficult to work with. I used to record in MP4 format, but that is, of course, very difficult to recover if OBS were to crash. MOV and MKV are both safer formats that will not lose your previous footage if OBS crashes in the middle of a recording, so either one of those is what I would recommend. I'm going to use MOV. I have experimented before with recording different audio tracks than I'm streaming. We're not going to do that in this video, but that is an option as well if you want to have audio tracks that you're recording but aren't sending out on your stream. And once again, the brunt of the recording options are going to be down here underneath encoder. Now the default is to use the stream encoder, which means you're encoding the video one time and your recording will be identical to what you're sending out to your streaming service. However, we're going to drop this down and we're going to select, once again, X264. Now even though this is the same option as we selected under streaming, the fact that we are now selecting X264 under recording instead of just using the stream encoder means we are going to have two instances of X264 running at the same time. And that is necessary so that we can have different options for each instance. Now here on our recording tab, we're not going to select rescale output because we want to record at the full resolution. So this is how we're going to be streaming at one resolution and recording at another. Like I mentioned, you can also control your bitrate separately for your recording, which is very nice. We can set this to 2500 kilobits per second or 3000. Or what I usually do is we don't even need to record at a constant bitrate. We can record at a constant rate factor, which is a constant quality that will adjust the compression based on what's happening on screen. That means you're getting higher quality video and smaller files. I'm going to set the constant rate factor to 18, that is what I use for most Nerd on the Street videos. And you can't use constant rate factor when you're streaming, because the streaming service needs to know exactly how many bytes to expect from your computer when it's streaming and processing your video live. But for recording, your video player, VLC or MPV or whatever you're using to play back that video, it's going to be able to look through the entire video file later and read this constant rate factor information. So it's perfectly fine to use that here for our recording. Keyframe interval, once again, we don't need to set this for our recording because video players are much more flexible when it comes to all these settings than streaming services are. And that's really all we need to do here. At this point, we can click Apply, OK, and I'm just going to add a scene here, or add a source into my scene. We'll add a screen capture. I'll just set this to my other screen. I'll center it here where my audio recording is coming in, and we'll split this into studio mode because that's how I normally look at it. And now we can go ahead and start streaming and recording. So you'll see here after a moment or two, our stream will start up and our recording is also going. You can see down here the separate timers for each one. Now if I open up my system monitor here, I didn't have it open before, but you can kind of see my CPU usage is ramping up a little bit. If I start moving around in the video, the window that's recording my sound, maybe we'll get a little bit more CPU usage as the X264 encoders have to encode a little bit more video. Now, one thing that's important to note is that it will use more of your local hardware resources to do this because you are running two encoders. So if you've got an NVIDIA graphics card and you're using hardware rendering, it will probably be no problem to run two encoders. If you are using software rendering like I am, it helps to have a lot of cores like I do here. If you've got a really low-powered computer, this might not be an option for you, and in that case, hopefully your upload speed is fast enough to just upload at the same resolution that you want to record at, but it is a trade-off that you get. In this case, I don't need as good upload speed to get a high-quality recording, but I do need a little bit more processor speed here on my system while I'm recording it. But we'll close out of our system monitor and we'll go here to Smashcast. And if we just go to smashcast.tv/nerdonthestreet, we should hear me here in a second. Yep, you can hear me right there. I'll go ahead and mute myself so that there's not an echo, but you see we are recording a delayed version of my audio recording there. And if I look at the quality here under our gear, we see source 720p HD. So we are sending Smashcast 720p footage. We can go into our live dashboard and see the stats, and video input here is good. We can look at the details. We are on constant bitrate because once again, streaming websites require constant bitrate. Our keyframe interval is set to 2. Bitrate is exactly 2000. That's exactly what we set up in OBS. But now I'm going to stop streaming and recording, and I'm going to open up my home folder on my system. Here's my home folder. You can see I've got a few files just laying around in my home folder here. I think I need to do a bit of housekeeping at some point. But here's the one that we just recorded, and I'm going to open that up. And as you can see here, I'll go ahead and mute this in MPV once again so that it doesn't echo in our video here. But I can make this a bit smaller, and we can see this is a 1080p video. Actually, here, I'll open it up in VLC so we can look at the stats. So VLC 2019 04 2300. Okay, so here's the video opened up in VLC. You can see you're currently watching a 1080p screen recording, and this thing barely fits within that screen recording because it is a 1080p recording itself. So we'll make it a bit smaller if we look at our codec information. Video resolution is 1920 by 1080. And of course, there's not very much going on screen here, but if I was to go ahead and have gameplay and stuff going on in the video, you would notice a distinct quality difference because the bitrate is much higher in the recording than it was on the stream. So that's all there is to it. Like I said, this was a very simple process. Just wanted to share that with you guys because it seems like kind of a common thing that people might want to do. OBS is a very powerful tool with a lot of options under the hood. Let me know if there's anything else you guys want to know how to do in that. And finally, before I go, I just want to mention that my videos are funded by the Nerd Club over at nerdclub.nots.co. You can join there for just $3 a month, and if tips like this are helpful to you, you can help me make more videos to share more tips. We are getting up there in our goals that we are trying to reach. We are at $35 out of our $50 goal for our self-sustaining servers, where we will no longer be losing money hosting my website. We're going to make a Nerd Street IRC server when that happens that people can chat in. And I do want to give a shout out to a new Nerd Club member, Emil Bratt, who just joined earlier today. So that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm Jacob Kaufman. I'm the Nerd on the Street, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.